What's up YouTube, this is Painey's Comics. Got another haul video for you today. I realised that last week I didn't show you guys what books I got that came out last week. I would show them now, but some of them I've put away, some of them I haven't, you know, so they're all in different places, so finding them would be a bit of a palaver. So I'm just going to read you real quick what I got last week. Here you go. Alright, so I got Justice League 45, Astonishing Ant-Man Baby Variant, Journey to the Star Wars, The Force Awakens, Shattered Empire 4, still a mouthful. Karnak Baby Variant, that one's really cool, check that out if you haven't already done so. S.H.I.E.L.D. 11, Uncanny Inhumans Baby Variant, and the regular cover, Age of Apocalypse number 5, Astonishing Ant-Man number 1 regular cover, Book of Death, Fall of XO, Manowar regular cover, well, A cover. I've got all the A covers for the Book of Death, so I'm keeping that up. Darth Vader number 11 and the regular cover for Karnak number 1. I've also ordered Diesel issue 2 from Boom Studios, but that still hasn't arrived yet, so I think I'm going to have to order that again from somewhere else. But with that said, on to this week. Alright, as you can see in front of you, this is Deadpool versus Thanos, issue number 4. It's the last one in the series, and another awesome Ron Lim variant. He's done pretty cool variants for this series. I'm pretty happy with those. They're definitely better than the regular covers, in my opinion. Chewbacca number 2, and this one from DC, Justice League The Dark Side War Batman. This takes place after issue 45, and it says in the end of the book, continues in issue 46. So if you read these in the order they come out, I think you'll get the story in the linear format instead of going back and forth or something. Originally, I thought these were part of this series, Justice League Gods and Monsters, because all of these titles were originally called Gods and Men, so they've changed the name of that. So, yeah, I said in the previous video they're part of this series. Well, I think they were part of this series. I was wrong on that one, but I'm glad because this Justice League series is much loved by everyone. And the Gods and Monsters comic, not so much. Alright, Book of Death number 4, last part of Book of Death. Black Magic number 1, Greg Rucka. Bit of a horror story, I'm told. Haven't dug into that yet, but Greg Rucka's an awesome writer, so I thought I'd give it a shot. Mercury Heat number 5. So far, I'm pretty. I wouldn't say it's a great book. It's good. I'd say if you haven't picked them up so far, wait. They'll probably go down in price. But yeah, I can't see that many of them being sold. So whether that's because not many of that are being ordered, I don't know, but yeah, I'm enjoying it. Can't wait to read issue number 5, last issue of the first story arc. I've got this, Z2 Comics, Welcome to the Show Side. I was looking through Previews World, I always do that, on like maybe the Friday, to see what's out the next week, and every time there's a number one, I'll look at the cover, read the description. Looks at the cover of this one, thought it's brilliant. So yeah, that's my reason for picking that up. And with these indie titles, you know, it's supporting the these younger, smaller companies, and that's obviously a good thing. Next up, we have Lumberjanes number one. No, it's not the real number one. This is their first sort of one shot. This is the, I guess, the first issue one of Lumberjanes that's not actually issue number one. I missed the boat on Lumberjanes, so I thought I'd pick this up, give it a read, see if I like it. I don't think it's going to be my thing, but you never know. Alright, so this next comic is called The Twilight Children. It's from Vertigo, and this isn't normally the sort of thing I'd pick up. I'd look at the cover and go, no thanks. But I was speaking to a guy on Twitter, Jake Scullion, something like that. Sorry, I've completely jacked up your name, bro, but oh well. Basically, we started talking because like, he said that he read Bloodshot Reborn, and he loved it, so he subscribed to a load of Valiant comics. And I said, oh man, that's Jeff Lemire, man, you know he does that, he's an awesome writer. And yeah, we got to talking, and he basically said that Twilight Children is a really rad book, and I should pick it up. So I have. That's my reasoning for getting this. Alright, next up. Invincible 124. So this is titled Reboot? So is it a reboot? No, not in my opinion. This is the first Invincible book I've ever read. And basically, the way it feels to me is walking into the middle of some random film in the cinema. Just in like the middle of the film, just taking a shot in the dark and see what you land on. This feels like maybe, I don't know, part four or something. Not part one or three. It was really weird. I can say the art is really cool. That's to my style. The writing's very good. Robert Kirkman is the writer of this. This is definitely not a good starting on point, in my opinion, for anyone of the series. But what it did do is make me want to read the series from the first issue, because some of the things in there seemed cool. They was quite rushed. I'm assuming that's because the people that have been reading this know what's going on already. But yeah, I'd definitely like to pick up the maybe, I don't know, the first omnibus or whatever they have of this when I get caught up with some more reading. Alright, so this, I'll do some variants. This is Web Witch, issue number one, and this is the wrap around cover. On the other side, it's got like a little guy who looks like the Wasp, but like male version. Obviously, the female is quite underdressed, and I think it's kind of cold wherever the hell she's lying. But you know, I saw this and I thought I'd pick it up. I mean, it's a $5.99 cover, but it's kind of a thick book. I had a quick flick through the inside. I don't think it's going to be to my taste, but the cover's cool, so that's why I got that one. Book of Death, Legends of the Geomancer, issue number 4. This is the last part of this series. And, yeah, I'll be digging into this at some point. Obviously, as you know, this is a 1 in 10 for Book of Death, issue 4. They claim it won't be reprinted anywhere, although I'm sure someone's or you put this on Kick-Ass Torrents. You never know. So, you know, look around, maybe able to find it somewhere. For this one, I paid £13.46. It's average, I suppose. Can't really complain. Next up, Spider-Man 2099, or 2099, that's probably how I should have said it. This is the Anchor Design variant, and is actually only 30p, well 20p more than cover price. So yeah, so it was £2.95, which is about $4.55. That's not bad, right? I think that's pretty good, and I'm sure these are like 1 in 10, so correct me if I'm wrong, but that's the cheapest I found them. I didn't see them anywhere else for that price. And this is another variant. This is the Leonardi variant. This one was a bit more expensive. This one was £5.25 altogether with P&P. That's about $8.10. Again, I think that's pretty good. And here we have the UK exclusive variant. This one I think is pretty cool. A, because it's the UK exclusive, and I live in the UK. Go England. And it has all your favourite Spidey heroes on it. Got Spider-Ham. I guess that's Superior Spider-Man. Silk. Normal Spider-Man. Obviously, 2099, Miles Morales, and Spider-Gwen. It's pretty cool, right? I think so. And it was £3.38. And apparently this was available at the con I went to, but I didn't see it anywhere. So, well, I got myself a decent coffee. Alright, next up. This is the Uncanny Inhumans number 1. This is the Addy Granoff variant. Now, I know I said before I'm not going to buy any Addy Granoff anymore, unless it's something really cool. I don't really think this is really cool, but I took a punt. I saw this on a speculation website. They basically said they thought this would go up to like £25 or some shit like that. So, no, I thought I'll take the chance on it. I found a copy, including P&P, it was £7.25, which is $11.18, according to Google. So, you know, I thought I'd take the chance on it, get it, see if I can flip it relatively quickly. But it's not picked up any traction. I think there's just too many variants and too many number ones at the moment, especially for Uncanny Humans. There's like 5 1 in 25 variants. So this one I think is a bit of a dud. But you know, when you read these speculation things, you know, you've got to take everything with a grain of salt. You've got to think about it and make your own decision. Don't just buy it because they said so. Their reasoning to me seemed sound, that's why I took the chance on it, but you know, that's always up to you, you know. Alright, next up, Star Wars Fan Expo variant. By Salvador Lacara, I believe his name is. I'm really sorry if I jacked up your name. You're probably not watching anyway. Yeah, I like this cover, and he was supposed to be going to Brighton Film and Comic Con, which I'm going to this weekend. So I thought, hell, you know, buy it with P&P, $7.25. I think that's a reasonable price. It's in really nice shape. I should probably send this to CGC anyway, it's that good. But he cancelled for reasons unknown, so I'm a bit disappointed. But I'm glad to have this comic because it's really nice. It's one of the best, and it's one of the best Star Wars variants, I think, anyway. And there are a lot of Star Wars variants, so to say that it's one of the best is highly. Damn, what's the word? Flattering? I don't know. Let's go with that. But, probably my favourite variant I've seen in, I don't know, a year. I don't know, I'm pulling shit out of my ass now. Yeah, this is Invincible Iron Man number one, and this is the Midtown Comics. And I'm going to get his name right this time because I've got it written next to me. John Tyler Christopher variant. How can you not like this? I'm really sorry about the glare, it's in Mylar. You can see that it's Deadpool playing with all the toy variant toys. Turn upside down. Don't have to move the camera. But yeah, that is pretty cool. You see he's taking them out of the boxes. He's playing with them. He's got those on his shelf. How cool is that, man? And all together with P&P, it was £8.25. And I'm glad that I found this. Because I was really tempted to pay an extortionate amount of shipping to get this sent from Midtown Comics all the way across here. So yeah, I'm glad that I found this. As soon as I saw that it was on sale there, I was like, boom. Put in the basket. Shit, I should have ordered more of these. It's just awesome. This is just a brilliant cover. This is the best action figure comic cover. Simply because it's Deadpool playing with the action figures. And you've got all of them on there for the Marvel relaunch. I'm amazed. This is just a great cover. Absolutely great cover. If you don't like it, I think there's something wrong with you, but yeah. I'm sure you guys stateside can get a hold of this relatively easy, probably cheaper than I got it for. But yeah, I'd get it. This is the one to get, and I'm just rambling now. Alright, so here we have Jessica Jones Alias Volume 2. I've been trying to get hold of Alias Volume 2 for a while now. And I can't seem to get it anywhere. And then they brought out the new series where they've added Jessica Jones' name to the top. So I was able to get Volume 2 so I can read Volumes 3 and 4, which I have, because I've read number 1. But the only thing is, see, here's the spine. It's got a picture down, a face down at the bottom. It says Volume 2, and it's in white. But all the ones I got are in black. And obviously they don't say Jessica Jones on the side, but that's cool. This is the only way I was able to get hold of the copy, and I want to read it all. I want to read the last 3 volumes before this series starts, so I can be up to date and know everything that's happening, who everyone is. I like that stuff. Makes me feel good. yeah, I paid with P&P £10.64. But it's a bit more than I want to pay for a graphic novel. Especially something like 5 issues. But yeah, I want to read it. Alright, so this is from Image Comics. This is A Voice in the Dark, issue number 1. Issue 2. Issue 3. 4. 5. And 6. Of the 7-part series. I got all these from one seller. It was weird though, because they were selling 1 to 4 in one set, and then 5 and 6 separately, which is really weird, because that issue number 5 is like part 3 of an arc. But it's alright, I got issues 1 to 6 of the 7-part series from the same seller, and they was £17.35 or £2.89 each. And I also got number 7, and that one was free, because I got it from a different seller. He said it was in great condition, and the back is kind of jacked up, or really jacked up. Yeah, so I wanted to send it back to him, ended up just getting it for free. Obviously, he knew he was lying. But, yeah. But it's okay. Issues 1 to 6 are very fine to like near mint negative. Most of them are like near mint negative, very fine near mint. There's only one that's like very fine. But issue number 7, probably like fine, very fine. I mean, it doesn't look too bad from the front in the bag, but once you take it out, it's not very good. But I've got all 7 issues. And the reason I did that is because the author, Lemire Taylor, posted on his Twitter, I hope you guys have your A Voice in the Dark comics. So, you know, speculation sites were saying, oh, you know, it could be a series or something. And if this originally started out as a Kickstarter, so if you've got like the Kickstarter one, I saw a slab 9.8 sell for like $700 or something crazy like that. But the image ones are sort of reprints, but still good books to get. And also, the guy's doing a crowdfunder at the moment, because the guy who does this, he writes it and draws it, he can't use his arms, so he draws with his mouth. So that's straight up amazing right there. But his wife has cancer, and he needs money, obviously, to pay for the treatment. So that's something you should check out. Really good cause. Alright, see, this is what happens when you don't make videos in a while. They go really long. I'm sorry about that, people that like short videos. One thing I want to talk about, I got this with some of my comics. Yeah, Titan Comics preview. And here's one of the comics in here, The Troop. This is by Noel Clark. And I've been reading a lot about this comic in interviews and stuff from Noel Clark. If you don't know who Noel Clark is, he's a British actor, director, producer. He's been in, starred in and involved in lots of great British films. And in these interviews, he was talking about like the comics that he was reading growing up. And basically, you know, as a teenager, the books based for teenagers, because of the comic code, they couldn't really talk about like serious issues like sex, drugs, and all that sort of stuff. So that's something that he wants to put in here. And I think that's really good. I love his work. I see it in comic form. It's basically going to be like the X-Men. Let me read you the little blurb that they got in here. You can focus on that. Across the planet and unknown to each other, a group of troubled teenagers lead lives of quiet desperation, but hell is about to befall them, and they find their lives destroyed when they are targeted by dark forces. On the run, they discover they have unbelievable powers and must come together as the troop. I think you should all look into that. Titan Comics, as you guys know, did Bloodthirsty, which sold out before it even hit the shelves. I think this could be another one. Just from knowing the guy's work, I think, as a fellow comic reader, he will be able to put what he does on the screen into comics. So I think that would be really good. Alright, so here's what I got in this month's subscription boxes. Suicide Squad number 25, the Comic-Con box variant. Not really a variant, no, it's a reprint, but you know. The Harley Quinn one sells really well, so I hope that's another good seller. This is the Invincible Iron Man number 1 variant from the Collector Corps. Quite a few of these issues are jacked up because of the way they put him in the box, but this one seems to be okay. And from Comic Block, standard Heroes of Vengeance variant, this Tomb Raider variant, and Back to the Future variant. I guess this one's also in nerd block, because it's got nerd block at the bottom. But hey ho. Alright, here we have the Sire, I believe that's how you pronounce it. Number 9, this is something I backed on Kickstarter about a year ago. Yeah, it took quite a while to come. But what I did was, because it's come all the way from America, and I'm not going to order one book because shipping will be astronomical, and it's like issue number 9. What I did was, I paid $30 plus shipping to have all 9 issues. So here's issue 1, 2, 3, technically 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. They're all signed by the guy, which is nice. And for this one, I decided for the thank you letter, or thank you messages in the back, I would get Painey's Comics. This is the first time I've had my YouTube channel name in a comic or in anything. Normally I use my gamer tag, which I normally use for everything, or my name, but this time I thought, you know, it's a comic, I got a comics channel, I'll do that. So I thought that was pretty cool. Issue number 9 is in really nice shape. Shame the others aren't. Like I said, this was delayed for a year, and I paid $30 plus shipping to get all 9 books, and the guy sends them in a Jiffy light bag with 3 backing boards, 3 bags, 3 comics per bag. Issues 1 to like 6. They've got crap loads of colour breaks on them. They're not in very good condition. And it just feels like the bloke doesn't care. I mean, send them in a Jiffy light all the way across the pond with nothing but the smallest amount of bubble wrap that's in those Jiffy lights and 3 backing boards. I thought it was pretty poor. I don't even know if I can be bothered to read this anymore. It feels like he doesn't care about my custom. Why should I care about his book? That's the way I feel. I'll probably message the guy. I don't know. But, ending this on a positive note, and hopefully in under 30 minutes. This is Batman 666. Or 666. Or the Devil issue. Whatever you want to call it. My parents went on holiday, and they phoned me up, and they was like, guess where we are, son? I was like, well, I don't know where. Oh, we're in a comic store. I was like, oh, cool. And they're like, oh, is there any particular issues you want? And I'm just, like, laughing. That's annoying. You know, because there's obviously lots of comics that I want. So I just start beating them off, Captain Marvel 14, 17, you know, anything that you can think of. Like, he's like, oh, we've got Batman. I was like, oh, shit, yeah, Batman. Started listing out the Batman books, you know, 375, first Jason Todd, all that. I said, 666, and he was like, looking through, he found it. I was like, oh, okay, cool. And, he said it was £6. I was like, okay, that's cool. So I'm looking it up, I'm describing it to him, making sure that it's the right one, and, you know, I check it out, and for £6, as long as it's in fine, very fine, or above, then I'm evening the money. So I like ask him, you know, what sort of, condition it's in. He doesn't know comics, but he was like, oh yeah, it looks good to me. I was like, okay, screw it. As long as it's in very fine condition, or above, I've made my money. And, you know, he comes home from his holiday, he brings it. It was only £3. I was like, huh, even better. And it is in pretty good condition. There's some spine stress, so the spine would need, obviously, a press. But there's not really much point in that, because on the back, where it's been rolled, there's some colour breaks. But I mean, that's not major. And the only issue that you can see really on the front, I don't know if you can see that well, but there's a slight colour break on the corner. Very, very small. If it would focus. I'm sorry, it's not going to focus. But yeah, it's very, very small. That's the only noticeable thing on the cover. The corners don't look too bad to me. But yeah, so I'm thinking maybe an 8.0, maybe. Obviously, I'm not the best grader. I'm not going to lie to you guys. That's just what I think, using the best of my knowledge. So I think I've made out pretty well. Or my dad, more specifically, made out pretty well. So it's only £3 in the end, even though I thought he said 6. So yeah, it looks like my dad's better at finding bargain comics than I am. So yeah, it's very happy. I'm happy with that. I was very happy that my parents thought of me while I was on their little holiday break. And yeah, now I have a first Damian Wayne as Batman, which is why this book's so valuable. So yeah, if you can pick this up, do so. Near mint copy of this, £15 is a good price, $20. So if you can get, you know, work it out from that. But yeah, this is a book that I'd recommend, especially with the new Batman. You never know where it's going to go. Batman v Superman, followed by the solo movies. But yeah, I was very happy. So yeah, I'll probably never sell this comic. It's kind of now got sentimental value, thanks to my mum and dad. So yeah, it's pretty cool. Alright, that's the end of, I'm pretty sure, my longest video ever. Thanks for sticking around. If you did stick it around this long, write in the write in the comments below, 666, and that way I'll know you watched to the end. So I'd really appreciate it if you did that. Also, like and subscribe if you already haven't done so. And I'm going to start waffling now. Stop waffling. I'm just going to end it there. Peace.